In the previous video of quantum uncertainty, we had known why the exact position and exact speed of an object cannot be measured simultaneously in quantum physics. In quantum physics, there is always uncertainty in the simultaneous measurement of the position and momentum of an object. The uncertainty relation between them is given by this equation. But there are two questions related to this relation. First is, what is the physical meaning of delta in this equation? Means, how uncertainty is measured for any quantity. Second question is, why is this relation of uncertainty in position only with momentum? Why not with any other quantity? We will know the answers of both questions in this video. Sometimes the uncertainty relation between position and momentum is represented by this equation. But actually, this relation is not in its standard form. This is because the symbol delta used for uncertainty. The quantum uncertainty in the measurement of a quantity is the standard deviation in the measurement of that quantity, which is represented by sigma, not from delta. Therefore, the standard form of the uncertainty relation between position and momentum is given by this equation. Now, first of all, let's know what is the meaning of standard deviation. Let us understand this with an example. Suppose this is the data set for the measurement of a quantity. If we talk about its average or mean value, then it is given by this equation. Now, the difference between a quantity and its average is called deviation in the measurement of that quantity. It is represented by delta. If the average of this deviation is squared, then it is the square of the standard deviation in the measurement of quantity, which means standard deviation is the root mean square of deviation in the measurement of quantity. If we simplify this, standard deviation can be defined with this formula. This is the mathematical form of standard deviation. Talking about the physical meaning of standard deviation, then standard deviation is a quantity which tells how much the members of a data set differ from the mean values of that set. Low standard deviation means that the values of the members of the set are quite close to the mean value, while large standard deviation means that the values of the members of the set are significantly spread over the mean value. Hence, the quantum uncertainty relation between position and momentum is defined in this way, where sigma x and sigma p are standard deviation in the measurement of position and momentum. Now, second question is, why the uncertainty in the measurement of position comes only with momentum? Why not with any other quantity? To understand this, we need to define the uncertainty relation for any two arbitrary observables A and B. If the standard deviation in the measurement of any two observables A and B is sigma A and sigma B, then the quantum uncertainty relation between them is given by this equation. This relation is the general form of quantum uncertainty, where AB denotes the commutation relation between A and B. The commutation relation between any two observables A and B is defined by this relation. If the commutation between two observables equals to zero, then these observables are called compatible observables. Such observables share the same eigenfunction. For compatible observables, quantum uncertainty equals to zero, means that they can be measured simultaneously with 100% certainty. If the commutation between two observables is non-zero, then such observables are called incompatible observables. Such observables do not share the same eigenfunction. The quantum uncertainty for incompatible observables is non-zero, which means they cannot be measured with 100% certainty simultaneously. Talking about position and momentum, then both these observables are incompatible observables, whose commutation is non-zero iota h bar. This is the reason that position and momentum cannot be measured with 100% certainty simultaneously. The uncertainty of at least h bar by 2 will always be there in their measurement. In the previous video of quantum uncertainty, we knew that the reason for the existence of the quantum uncertainty is the dual nature of particle, which is called wave-particle duality. In the next video, we will learn about the wave-particle duality concept of de Broglie and interesting facts related to matter wave.